Praise the Lord! Wretched Knucklehead here, a.k.a. Brother Everly Jr. Brothers and sisters, we turn our Bibles to Luke chapter 2, and we'll be looking at verses 8 to 11, and it reads, "And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord." May the Lord add a blessing to the reading, to the hearing, to the admission, to the application, to the distribution of this great word, taken from the greatest book that man could ever possess. And my brothers and sisters, this is God's word. We give God all the honor, all the glory, all the praise, in the precious name of his Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. Amen. So our Lord and Savior Jesus is born. And when he's born, the Bible mentions how the flocks were at the night being tended by the shepherds. And the angel of the Lord came, and the glory shone round about. So midnight became midday. And during that time, it was a tumultuous time for God's people. They were under a tyrannical, evil, demonic leader by the name of Herod that just was absolutely devilish. And yet, there's our Lord and Savior Jesus being born at the darkest hour of the children of God. And he came and he shone his light. And while God's people were sleeping in the night with this evil, wicked king in rulership, there's our Lord and Savior born in the night and making it day, such that the shepherds were bewildered. And then the angel of the Lord said, "Fear not, behold, I bring good news of great tiding. For unto you this day in the city of David is born to you a Savior, Christ the Lord." Such that when Mary had to ponder about that, the shepherds were going out and preaching this message to all to hear. Such that when in the eighth day, our Lord and Savior Jesus was circumcised, and under Levitical laws in Leviticus chapter 12, Mary purified herself and couldn't use a lamb because the was poor, so they had to use she had to use a turtle dove and a pigeon dove to for purification. And so when, as time passed by, with this evil king Herod that's picked up in Matthew chapter 2, we see wise men coming from the east, an entourage, a group of wise men. And they go to this evil king, Herod, and they say to him, and this is in Matthew chapter 2, they say, "Where is the king of the Jew?" So this evil king, recognizing that they didn't come for him, they came for somebody else. And he's angry, and he's jealous, and he calls his spiritual leaders to go open up the Bible and find out, about this king of the Jews. And they get back to him and he said that he's going to be born in Bethlehem. And then he tells these great wise men that come in an entourage that, when you do go find him, please tell me so I could worship him. And the prophet, wise men, thought better of it and realized he didn't know what he was talking about. So they went to look for the king of the Jews. And a star guided them. And when the star guided them, they came to the house. And there was a child with Mary. And that child, probably at this point now, 2-3 years old, is our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And these wise men, when they came to the house and they saw our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, albeit 2-3 years old, They bowed their knees and they worshiped him. And they had gifts for our Lord and Savior and soon to come King Jesus Christ. They had gifts of gold. And this gold represents the deity of Jesus Christ. They were responding to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. They also had frankincense. This frankincense represents how they were reaching out for their priest. The frankincense was an aroma when the high priest would do their ceremonies and their prayers and lighting the candles, and they would have incense. And incense was such that it was a sweet smelling aroma to God, reminding that of a sweet smelling aroma to God of all, his son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. So the frankincense represented that. You know, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, when we think about his character, he came as a servant. He came as a servant. And when he was a servant, he didn't come to be ministered, but to minister. And as that role as a servant, he was a servant to sinful man, where he would heal the sick, he would feed the hungry, and he would teach the multitude of the gospel of the kingdom of God. He was also a sacrifice. It was a sacrifice such that where he offered himself, where he was at the cross, where he was beaten when we should have been beaten. He was tortured when we should have been tortured. He was mocked when we should have been mocked. He was executed when we should have been. He was our sacrifice. And then, which leads us to the other gift that these wise men brought, was the myrrh. And this myrrh speaks of receiving Jesus as our Savior. You know, again, he was our servant in the times like that. He met our needs. He was our sacrifice, where he took what we deserve and he took it on him. And the myrrh represents where he's our Savior, where we receive him as our Savior. You know, in Mark chapter 15, when Mark records the when Jesus was on the cross, and there was a point where in Mark chapter 15, verse 38, where they took the myrrh and they mixed it with wine. And this was like a narcotic, a sedative, because Jesus was enduring the pain and of taking the sins of the world. But when they gave him that myrrh mixed in with that wine, the Bible said he did not take it. And the reason why he did not take it, because he wanted to take the pain and the hardship of all our sins, our iniquities, and our transgressions. He didn't want it to be alleviated. He wanted to take that pain. And it's that myrrh, again, that represents why we receive him as our Savior. Because in John chapter 19, we see Joseph of Arimathea and Nicodemus, who at one point, who was of the religious leaders, but he believed on our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, where they took the body of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and in taking the body of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, they anointed it with myrrh. They anointed it with the spice, because Jesus Christ is our Savior, and he came to save us from our sins. So despite When the darkness in your life, the darkness, the hardship, know that when Jesus came, when Jesus was born, he was born in the middle of the night. And he turned that middle of the night, while you were sleeping, while you were resting, he turned that middle of the night into day, so that he could be the God that he is. We recognize the gold, recognizing him as deity. Recognizing with the frankincense, because he's our high priest. And recognizing the myrrh, because he's going to be our Savior. And that is our Lord, our Savior, and soon to come King Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord! May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord's face shine. that upon you. May the Lord lift up his countenance to you. May the Lord give you his peace. And I commend you all to God and to the word of his grace, which is able to build you up an inheritance to those who are sanctified in the precious name of his Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. And now to him that is able to keep you from falling and present you faultless in the presence of his glory, both glory, majesty, dominion, power, both now and forevermore. Praise the Lord. Amen. Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King, peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconcile. Joyful all ye nations rise, join the triumph of the skies, with the herald angels host proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. God the herald angels sing. Praise the Lord. Glory to the newborn King. God bless. Agape love.